Okay, I've taken I took a quick break. But it's only been about 5 minutes. And yeah, let's carry on. Let's find out where we are. Uh-oh, we're Vala's Nightlands. Shit. Oh, maybe I shouldn't have saved in here. Why, I thought I heard something on the other side of my wall. Hello, stranger. Although perhaps condolences are now in order. You, like me, are in the Nightlands. You're in the Nightlands, it only crosses one way. Shit. Back here again, then. So, now we know it is the right door that we need to go through. How are we meant to learn that fact, though? Let's, let's try another question and see if I could at least... Which door would the other guard tell me is correct? The other guard would tell you the left door. So if Glisp is telling the truth... God, this really hurts my brain. If Glisp is lying, then the other guard is telling the truth. So if I ask the other guard the same thing... Oh God, it still doesn't clear things up in my brain. I can't do it. Damn, this is tough. Alright, before I go through, I'm gonna like try and work this out. Give me a minute. Okay, yeah, I've written a little diagram and I think I understand. That's, you wanna ask about what the other guard would say. Because the liar would tell you, in this case the liar is Glisp, he's going to tell you the left door. What's his name? Thoth is going to tell you the right door because he tells the truth. If you ask Thoth what the other guard would say, he'd tell the truth. So he'd tell you that Glisp would tell you to go through the left door. And you ask him what the other guard would say. Yeah. He'd say the left door. And if you ask him what the other guard would say, he'd say the left, because he would say the right, but he's lying. So, if you worked it out and kind of do what I've done and make a chart of what they would say, if you ask either of them what the other guard would say, they'll both say the same thing, and it would be the incorrect door. So the thing to do is ask them what the other guard would say. You'd get the same answer from either, and not choose that door. That's what you should do. Could I have worked that out without knowing the answer? And knowing he was lying already? No, probably not. Maybe eventually. But I've been in here for... way too long already. Okay, same thing again. Let's not wind up in a some Daedric purgatory again. What was it, the Nightlands? I don't want to go there again. Weaver? Can't speak to him. Oh, we're here. I've just realised as well, I think she's, like, seriously massive. I advise you ask carefully, mortal. What you ask, I will grant. Oh no. Are you not content with a lifetime of knowledge? What else is there for you then? Tell me what it is you desire. I have no choice this time. If I need time to think, I can't leave. I can kind of just see back into the shop there. So I guess I'm going to have to wish for power and no doubt pass another test. Power over men and myrrh. Good request, mortal. Looks like I can make you the most powerful in the world. What is that, a door? Wait, Cyrodiil Imperial Palace. See, maybe some houses over there? Can't really tell. Is that? Is that White Gold Tower? Okay. We're all excited for the celebration tonight, my lord. Okay. Office of the Potentate. The Potentate? Wait. The Potentate Virsidu Shai and his son, Saverian Charak. Is there always a potentate in a Cyrodiil? Just weird that, because I never really hear that word. I don't really know what it is. It's strange that we came across it twice. Imperial Audience Chamber.
was that?
Letter to Potentate. I'd like to thank you for the gift of rosemary and sage. I was delighted when I received it the other day. Wait, after much trial and error, I regret to conclude that I will not be able to restore the vision in His Majesty's right eye. Wait a minute, this is... Something's going on here. I'm sure I saw. Okay, Hugo. But the message itself is very orthodox, said Corda, looking up into his one good eye. Emperor Reman III only had one eye. So are we here at the assassination of Reman III? My lord, allow me to introduce some early guests who come bearing gifts for us. The Dunmeri, as you know, are quite ready to officially end this fourscore war. Here we are. That's the treaty that Vivek, at the start of that book as well, Vivek was meant to go and sign some treaty or something, wasn't he? I'll let you settle in. We must continue to get ready before our guests arrive. A land your great-great-grandfather united under one final Cyrodiilic Empire. It is you, your majesty, who carries his name. And this day you have brought a historic peace between the two worlds, ours and... Wait a minute, I'm not... Your great-great-grandfather, Reman Cyril... Oh no. I am Reman III. And this is the day of my assassination? I wished for power. Again, be careful what you wish for.
There's someone watching me. I can tell.
A blessing from our Lord Vivek and Sothisil. We bring gifts from Morrowind in celebration of this momentous occasion. Treasures from our land and a symbol of our good faith in the agreement. We hope the divide between our two peoples will cease to exist after tonight. Where is Vivek? He's late, I believe. God, do you have a drink? Aye, congratulations, Your Majesty. I'd be hard-headed not to offer you a warrior's drink for all you've done for this country. What did you give me? Skingrad Winery, vintage 2920. Wine? No, I need something stronger. Argonian marsh sap. Guli cattle wines. Akavuri spice wine. Look, I have a feeling I'm going to have a stressful night, so I'm taking. I'm going to help myself to your booze. Basically, Emperor Riemann III turns alcoholic tonight.
Strange.
Yeah, tell me about it. I need to get out of here, don't I? I can't stay here. It was Julek. Emperor's shield. Might need it. The fourscore war, it's over, and while some will continue to feel animosity on both sides, I know that eventually this can lead to a new prosperity for both of our peoples, with respect shared among both Cyrodiil and Dunmer. I'm glad to share this moment with you, Emperor, and to be an invited guest on this day where history is made is an honour. Oh, just you wait, history hasn't started yet. Here's the feast that we'll never get to eat. Not if we stay here anyway. Can I escape down here? No. I have a terrible feeling that there is no escape. Conspiracy. Emperor, I have but little time for this note to reach you. I fear my previous letters have been found and dispersed by those closest to you, and I have but one chance to warn you. A conspiracy is formed against you in the palace. They intend to kill you at tonight's ceremony. Beware of those you consider close. When the palace is locked, all hope is lost. May gods protect you, a friend. Oop, that was weird. Couldn't move then for a second. Okay, I don't think I can take that. Oh, this Weaver. Let's go chat with him. Corda, She's in here. Said Gorda, looking up into his one good eye with a single, blinding motion, she brought the letter up under the Emperor's chin. His eyes widened and blood poured down the blank parchment. Blank, that is, except for a small black mark, the sign of the Morrig Tong. It fell to the floor, revealing the small dagger. She's the one who does it. Riemann, my sweet dear, how marvellous our celebration will be tonight, to know that you have brought a peace to the world that even your father and grandfather could not achieve. It is a testament to your wisdom and power. I'm certain they will be talking about this day for centuries to come. I'm on to you, Corda. Can I just kill her? The Treaty of Pildrum. That's the treaty to be signed. Ralagius Anarel. I don't believe I've seen a high elf with such a grand outfit. Okay, no, he's saying the wrong thing. This is like some terrible dream, isn't it? Assassination attempts, my king, after the terrible news of Juliet's murder at the hands of assassins. His armor's over there, isn't it? I've ordered a full audit of the palace, the Imperial Guard, and of other high-ranking legionnaires in an effort to find out how this plot was carried out, and if, in fact, your suspicions are correct that a larger, more organized conspiracy is at play. And this is written by the snake guy who's in on the conspiracy. God damn it. Note saying that he's going to be late to the ceremony. He's present though in the book. List of complaints. 3 times yesterday I asked for butter flour for the butter cakes, and 3 times did I receive a manure that would have made a beggar pleased to spit it out. Okay, this is just seems to be just trivial complaints. I don't know if that's important. Let's speak with Weaver. Wait, I know it. I remember reading about this. This is the story of assassination. This is the night the Emperor was assassinated. I know. We've worked that much out. If anything happens tonight, I'll try to get us out of here. Just try not to die. I'll do my best, Weaver. Now what do I do? Come, Riemann, assume your throne and be approached. I hear many nobles stirring to have a meeting with you and to hear your lore. A somewhere up here. Is this my throne? Oh yeah, here we go. Approach me, subject.
Oh, where did I put that?
Your Imperial Majesty, the Council has advised me to bring to your attention the question of mercenary and foreign legions drafted into our army, and the desire now that many people have to begin a process of dismantlement in some of the Imperial armies, beginning with those from abroad and those not necessary to defence, now that the war is ended. I would like now to introduce to you a letter here that has come from a representative of those soldiers from the Rift, who presently remain stationed in the Nibene Basin, and many of whom have not returned to their families in several years. Now that word has reached them that the war is officially ended, they grow anxious without a date with which they can expect to return to Skyrim. Oh my god, being Emperor is hard work. Of course, as many of the Council have noted, dismantling the Imperial armies is a great relief of cost, and it would be immensely beneficial to forego the expense of maintaining any... Look, just... send a signal to dismantle the armies from abroad, whatever. We've got other things on our minds, we don't care. Next subject. Here we go. Reman Cyrodiil, we meet again. I am a landowner here in Cyrodiil and have supported your great empire from the beginning. As an avid loyalist to this one true empire, allow me to thank you with deepest regards for this mighty peace you have arranged. Today I come, though, to settle a matter because I know your word is fair and just. In the wake of the Empire's taking Ald Lambassi, I had land that was recognized under my ownership by the Dunmer, yet as of now has been seized from me without payment or recompense by the Imperial Army. I had paid for this land, invested in cultivating it, and in a day it has been taken without notice or award. Now you will remember the funding I gave to the troops at the River Connellus, an aid that allowed your army to press into Morrowind at a time when the Nibene heartland was likely to be invaded. An aid I gave selflessly and for the love of this great empire. So I ask you, Emperor, will I receive the land surrounding Ald Lambassi that are properly mine? No. No, basically. It does not give me pleasure to see that land taken away, yet I yield it before your majesty. Who are they up there? Your Majesty, the Potentate has arrived. Oh, do I need to go up there, I think? Can I get up there? Now, I thought he was some kind of snake person. Yeah. I guess maybe the modder just didn't really have the resources to make a snake person. Hello, Your Majesty. I hope I found you well. We've received a messenger from Vivek. Apparently they've come with urgent news. I think it would be best if Your Imperial Majesty met him alone. Right, this is right out of the book, isn't it? Skooma? I don't know why I can ask about Skooma. I don't know why I did. I've taken the liberty of having the messenger come meet us in the audience chamber. You'll have privacy that way. I've ordered the chamber cleared. They are downstairs. What? Where? You know what, this really reminds me of, this is just like something that would happen in Pathologic or something. Ah! Oh my god, there's loads of them. I can survive this, the hidden heart.
That's all you've got.
Belt of the Arm of God. Swap swords.
That's your best time.
Tong helmet, I don't have one of those. Interesting. I don't like this place, Siltanalia. Me neither. Get me out of here. Let's go. Okay. Okay, we made it out alive. That was quite surreal, wasn't it? Let's see what else Mephala has in store for us. Two requests I have already granted, and yet here you stand satisfied with neither. Nevertheless, my generosity knows no bounds. Tell me what you desire, you need only ask. The wishes only lead to calamity. I want to leave this place behind. If it is freedom you seek, it would only come with an agreement reached by both of us. Leave this place, seek the one who used my lamp before you, and you will learn what you must do. Okay. Let's get out of here. Seek the one who used the lamp before us. Okay. Speak with Weaver actually before we leave. Okay, we can't. So it could be. What was his name? Jovira? Who was in this shop previously. Or it could be the woman who sold it to me. Those are my only ideas so far, so let's get the hell out of here and go do some asking around. Oh. We're free. Finally. Ah, Varden fell, and a storm, and outside, and real rain from the actual Third Era. I am never messing with Daedric Princes again.